multiple losses. He's had fights against the likes of Oscar Valdez, suffered a loss to Carl Frampton as well. The current combined record of the four opponents that have beaten Avalos, 122-9-3. Valdez, Smart, and Frampton all managed to avoid knockdowns in... Leo Santa Cruz. Very proud of living here in Los Angeles. The world champion. The flash bulbs are going off for the 29-year-old. What a career he has had. He's been a world champion for 5 years before the loss to Frampton. And now, defending his title here at the StubHub Center in Carson. Leo watched the fan favorite, the fans supporting him. They love watching Leo fight here. A left hook that landed for Chris Avalos to start. Leo, over a minute has elapsed. And Leo's always smiling. That's one thing about him. He loves fighting. He loves being a world champion. A right hand on the chin by Santa Cruz. Another one. He's backing up Chris Avalos. And Leo picking up the action. That's the end. Very sharp. A left hook that connected for Avalos. Leo shoots out that jab. Leo has that right hand almost like in a spring. He always shakes it and he gets ready to throw it. Avalos looking to cut off the distance. Avalos is going to have to make this a rough and tumble affair. I'd have to see borderline dirty in order to cut the distance off. Leo uses his reach very well. That jab is coming out. And Avalos goes to the body of Leo. Thomas Taylor. Couple of right hands for Santa Cruz, pinning Avalos against the ropes for a quick moment. And he is connecting from all kinds of angles. It's Santa Cruz, a right hand that backs up Avalos. Leo just continues to throw. It is nonstop action from the very beginning when it comes to Santa Cruz. Avalos throwing, but it is clear that Santa Cruz is beating him to the punch in the first round and a half. An uppercut that landed for Avalos. If you're Santa Cruz, the goal is to wear down Chris Avalos. He took some of the blueprint from there and is going to try to execute his own game plan to defeat Avalos. And Avalos has tripped over his own feet. Luckily, he got okay, and it wasn't because of a punch. Under a minute remaining in the second. A left hook that connected for Santa Cruz. And a right hand pushing Avalos against the ropes. That's some heavy firepower from the world champion. He's executing his game plan. He's in very good shape. As he always is. And now Avalos is bringing the fight to Leo, and Leo is willing to oblige. They are standing in the center of the ring and going toe-to-toe in the early going of this third round. And Leo steps inside with the left hook. He's bigger than Avalos. You can tell the size difference is in the favor of Santa Cruz. Left side of the ear of Avalos. Nice sharp right hand on the chin. S- Santa Cruz continues the walk down. Chris Avalos. Avalos trying to step inside, but it is Santa Cruz who is having control and a right hand, echoing right hand. Santa Cruz with the right hand right on the abdomen. Another one. Dig into the body of Santa Cruz. An uppercut on the body of Avalos. Leo being crafty and trying to break down the Lancaster, California resident. And here is some of the work from Santa Cruz as he stepped inside. This is how the round began. Furious action here. That was the first. And the second, a right hand pushing and pinning Avalos against the ropes. More of the third round, equally the same. As Leo going to work. Right hand down the middle. Leo mixing in. Big right hand that landed. And Avalos goes against the ropes. And left hook. That buckled Avalos. Avalos in some trouble. Avalos goes across the ring. Can Leo finish off Chris Avalos? Oh my goodness. Avalos is throwing back, but Leo is throwing with venomous intentions. Leo's got some pop behind his punches, just as Carl Frampton. And look at this by Santa Cruz. He is really picking up the pace here in the fourth round. 80 seconds left. Oh, what a sledgehammer of a right cross by Santa Cruz. Another one. Avalos standing, but he is going backwards. Another one. Thomas Taylor may stop this fight. Chris Avalos in some trouble. Santa Cruz trying to close up Chris Avalos. Santa Cruz throwing everything in the kitchen sink at him. He's backpedaling. Santa Cruz intensifying his assault. 50 seconds left. How Avalos is standing, I don't even know. A right hand down the middle. It is target practice for Santa Cruz as Avalos ties up. The chance of Leo here at the StubHub Center, where Leo is beloved. Oh, what an echoing right hand by Santa Cruz. He's got him rocked. Can he finish off Chris Avalos? Santa Cruz is pouring on and turning up the heat. Avalos is one tough customer. Leo still trying to dig down deep. But Avalos has not touched the canvas. And a big right hand on the chin. That ends the fourth. And Avalos takes out his mouthpiece, and his corner may stop this fight. His corner may stop it. They grabbed him. Taylor, Dr. Ayub is there, and here is some of the work by Santa Cruz in that round. A left hook right on the button. And there you see the corner. Chris Avalos is mugging you. But Avalos is talking to Chris, and that connector straight right cross for Santa Cruz. Another one. Avalos steps inside. A double jab followed by a right cross down the middle, partially blocked, but he also ate it. Did Avalos. 10 seconds remaining in this fifth round. Avalos has made a good account of himself, and now he steps inside but gets caught with the right hand. Avalos steps inside with the straight right hand and a left hook. They both exchange a close distance. Avalos stepping inside, but he gets backed up with the left hook. And look at this action as they are continuing to throw bombs in the center of the ring. So apropos that it's here at the StubHub Center. A big right hand. Straight right hand down the middle. Uses economical punching, doesn't waste too many motions. Avalos step inside. They are continuing now to mix it up at close distance. A right hand that backs up Avalos. A sweeping right hook on the body by Santa Cruz, followed by a left hook upstairs. And here's some of the work from what we are watching from Santa Cruz, picking up a right hand on the left's ear. more of Santa Cruz. That was when he was trying to. A big right hand that connected by Santa Cruz. And now Leo spins around Avalos with his head in between the third and the fourth rope. Avalos has got one heck of a chin on him because he has taken some heavy artillery. A left hook followed by a straight right, and Avalos goes backwards. And now Santa Cruz is trying to close out Chris Avalos. He's back on the offensive, and now Santa Cruz feels like he might have Avalos hurt with under 2 minutes remaining. He had a brief moment there, and a heavy right hand by Santa Cruz. Avalos is coming forward, but he's just coming on pure guts and determination. Santa Cruz really starting to unleash its hands. Oh my goodness, what a right hand! And Thomas Taylor errs on the side, caution, and waves it off. And what a victory for Leo Santa Cruz as Thomas Taylor waves off the mound after a heavy straight right hand. Chris Avalos is disappointed, but it was only a matter of time, and always err on the side of caution. A victory for Leo El Famoso Terremoto Santa Cruz, an eighth round stoppage victory. The fans here wanted to see Avalos go out on his shield, but it is Leo Santa Cruz who defends his championship and is successful in the process. Now the second half of the equation has been done. What a victory for Santa Cruz, as both Santa Cruz and Mares victorious here tonight at StubHub Center with Premier Boxing Champions. StubHub Center, and here's how the night concluded. Look at these punches that Avalos was not answering back to, and a big right hand there by Santa Cruz. And another one. Let's take a look at that. That was a jab followed by a right hand, and Thomas Taylor stepped in and said, that's enough. The official particulars on Leo Santa Cruz and his victory over Chris Avalos.